The effects of fasting, real quick. Fasting changes us. It doesn't change God. You don't fast to change God. Fasting changes the one who's fasting. Number two, fasting moves you into better positioning. Number three, fasting increases your spiritual capacity. Very important to understand this. When I began to study fasting and began to fast as a lifestyle, I was incredibly shocked at what I discovered in fasting. Not just from what I read and researched, but in my own experience with it. Fasting is like having a pipe in your house hooked up to a big tank of water. And this pipe has not been cleaned for a long time. So it has built up grit on the inside, and it keeps getting smaller and smaller to the point where there's just a little hole. Everything else is clogged up with rust and dirt and muck. The pipe is big, but the hole is small because it's all messed up with gunk. The amount of water in the tank is still the amount. But what you receive through your pipe is regulated by the size of your clogged up pipe. And if you're not careful, you can actually close that hole up completely. I wonder if there are people in here who are suffering from spiritual clogs. God says, look, I want to use you to reach the world through you. I want to solve that problem in your house through you. I want to solve that problem in your family through you. I want to solve that problem in your community through you. I want to solve that problem in your country through you. But I can't get through you. You're clogged up. Fasting is like Drano. Fasting is where you stop clogging and begin to allow purity to eat away the gunk so that your capacity comes back to its fullness. So that the force of God's power becomes so strong that anything you turn your pipe on is changed. That's what fasting does. It doesn't increase God. It increases you. Is that clear? So, the devil is so glad you are full of food. Could you imagine? You walk up to a guy filled with demons, and you clogged up. You start praying, in the name of Jesus, come out. Oh, Lord, the demon says, little, broom, broom, broom. Little drops coming through you. That's what happened to the disciples when they prayed for that demon-possessed boy. They were saved. They loved Jesus. They were with him, his disciples. But the demon says, we ain't coming out. Because the force it takes to get us out ain't coming through you. You eat too much. You watch TV too much. You're on the internet too long. How could you cast us out? You're on Facebook every single minute. You ain't got no power. And Jesus walked down the mountain and said, what's going on here? And the people were all in the village upset. And Christ says, what happened? And a man came and said, Lord, I brought my little boy to your disciples. And he's filled with a demon. And they could not cast him out, he said. Jesus Christ did not speak to the man or the boy first. He turned to his disciples first. And he asked them a question. How long must I be with you? In other words, I've been showing you what you should be doing. You're trying to do what I do without doing what I do. You think praying for the sick, it's because I can pray for the sick. He says, I dealt with that when I was fasting last week. My capacity is wider than yours. And then he said, bring the boy to me. And he just spoke. Out! Blown out. We know the story. At lunch that day, everybody was quiet, eating their nuts and dates. And then someone put up the courage and said to Jesus, Master, you know that incident this morning? Yes. You know, you embarrassed us, you know. What do you mean I embarrassed you? Yeah, you know, we. Why couldn't we cast the demon out? They said. We prayed. And you prayed. He says, this kind doesn't come up by prayer. Your capacity was too small. Demons love saints who like to eat. I mean, it seems as if the church has an eating ministry. On Sunday, you go to any restaurant, full of the saints. Not you, I'm talking about you now, you don't go. It's the one right behind you. These people are amazing. I know you. This ain't you, but you know, we go straight to food. It's like, yippee, we're free to eat now. It's a, and every buffet is filled with anointed people. We just love, you know, and the devil says, take more. And the devil know you come to prayer meeting, you know, go to eat first. He said, eat first. You need to eat first before you go to prayer meeting. Eat dinner before you come. Eat boy, eat girl. And he wants to come here with your belly full of food. You know, this prayer ain't going to work. You climbed up. He said, this kind doesn't come out except by prayer and fasting. The good news is, in the next few days, you will become a threat to the devil. You are going to become powerful. And the power is going to be because of your obedience to God in this consecration. This is why I get so excited about a fast. Because I know that I become more dangerous. Your capacity will increase. Number four, fasting breaks habits, spiritual bondage. Some of you don't know how powerful habits are. All I know is you suffer from them. It can be any kind of habit. Drugs, cigarettes, alcohol, sex, pornography, lust, all the stuff that you're fighting with. Even some of the barbiturates and some of the pills they're making you take for uppers and downers and all this stuff. You know, on a fast, fasting cleans you out so much. It breaks habits. I've met so many people who came to me with problems, with habits, as you know, from alcohol and drugs to pornography and sex. And I'd say, look, you go on a fast. And I want you to fast for 10 days. 10 days. In other words, you got to break the 8-day. No food, no company, it's you and the Word. And they come back to me, totally healed, no desire for anything. Except God. You go to psychologists, pay some money, go to psychiatrists and lay on the bed, talk about how much they deal, you know, and just go on a fast. Break it. It's a habit. Your healing shall rise like the sun. Number five, fasting quiets the heart. That's one of the benefits. So you can hear God better. Get ready to hear God like you never heard him before. But by the time you reach the 14th day, you're going to be a walking grenade. If someone pull you up, clip, you explode on earth. Because on the 14th day is the second day of freedom. The first day of freedom is when you hit the 7th day, and they hit the 8th day for new beginnings. The 14th day is the day that you become renewed completely. No hindrance. That's when your heart becomes totally pure before God.